Hello, my name's Stuart. Welcome to the channel. Today I'm going to show you how to send and receive SSTV images using your HF radio or even a computer if you don't have a HF radio. Now you can only send SSTV images if you have the relevant license to do so, but anybody can receive them. So don't forget, I'll be showing you how to do it even if you don't have a radio, so stick with me. Let's jump into it. Okay, so the first step is to search on Google for MMSSTV. Go to this website, MMSSTV by Hamsoft. Once you get here, look at the download section. We're going to install this version here. Once the download is finished, just click next and leave everything as default. Don't change the installation address. I've already got it installed, so the folder already exists, so I'll just continue anyway. Let's create a desktop shortcut for convenience so we can find it later. There we go. Once it's finished, we will launch MMSSTV. So here it is. This is MMSSTV. And as you can see, it's already receiving. We can tell because of this signal line here on the right hand side. In order for it to work, you must set up your sound card first. So go into Options, Setup, MISC, and this is where you put your sound cards. So think of this just like you would FT8 if you've done FT8 before. Just select your radio microphone as the input and your radio speaker as the output. If you don't have a radio, what you can do is install virtual audio cable and select line 1. Then what you would do is on your desktop sound settings, you would set the output to line 1 also. What will happen then is when we load up a Web SDR, it will channel the sound from your sound card into MMSSTV. Bear in mind, you will need to set your settings back to your normal speakers once you've finished, otherwise your computer speakers might stop working. But this is a way to get audio from your computer into MMSSTV. So we do have a radio, so we're going to use the radio settings here. The only other thing to do is if you do have a call sign, set your call sign in this section here. If you don't intend on transmitting, then don't worry about this part. Remember, you can only transmit if you've got the relevant license to do so. So that's the basics for sound card setup. To set up your radio, go to TX Radio Command and select the COM port for your radio, the correct baud rate and data bits and other settings. The settings on the screen are good for a 7300, however your COM port might be different. All of the other settings here are default, I haven't changed anything else. There we go, we're actually receiving an image now, although it's very noisy. But once you've got things working, MMSSTV will constantly monitor the frequency you're on for SSTV images. We're currently on 14.230 MHz, upper sideband data mode. That's the mode to use, especially if you intend to transmit as well. So once you get this far, you can just leave the program running in the background. Just remember to set your radio to the right frequency for SSTV for whichever band you're on. So there we go. That's how you install MMSSTV, connect it to your radio and start receiving SSTV images. Now, I did promise I'd show you how to do it without a radio as well, so let's jump back into it. Okay, so what we're going to do is fire up Station Master, which has a Web SDR built in. You don't have to use Station Master, but it gives us nice easy access to a Web SDR. So let's turn up the sound and see what we can hear. We need to make sure it's on upper sideband, and it is. There's just nobody transmitting at the moment, so we'll leave that there and turn down the volume slightly, but we'll have it on in the background. So what's happening now is my computer is sending the audio from the desktop into virtual audio cable 1. What we can do now is go back into the settings on MMSSTV and MISC and select audio cable, virtual audio cable 1 also. So now this is not receiving any data from my radio, it's receiving it via the Hackgreen Web SDR. Okay, so I will actually switch my radio off completely. I've now done that in the background. So the radio noise you can hear is coming from the Web SDR at Hackgreen. We're piping that data into MMSSTV, and if anybody transmits anything, then this would start receiving it without any radio involved whatsoever. So if you don't have a license or you just don't have access to a radio at the moment, you can do this and start receiving SSTV images. So there we go, how to receive SSTV via the internet or via your radio. Hopefully that's helped somebody get up and running on SSTV. There's a lot more to it when it comes to sending and replying to people, but we're not covering that in this video. Maybe we'll do that another day. I know there's a lot of videos out there on YouTube that do cover it in great detail. This is just a quick start guide on how you can install the app and start receiving images very quickly. If you like it, then obviously you can go off and find out how to reply and send images as well. But that's all for today. Thank you very much for watching, and don't forget to like, share and subscribe and everything else. There'll be a few more videos coming out over the next week covering Station Master. It will automatically track your received images and allow you to post them up to the SSTV site here and attach them to your logs. So if that's of interest, subscribe and you'll be notified of when I release those videos next week. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.